hope everybody's doing well and staying healthy. Today I wanted to do a planter, a DIY planter for a little succulent. So I have my succulent here, and today I'm going to make a little planter for it, and then I'm going to take it outside and plant it and show you guys how to do that as well. So I'm hoping that this will turn out to look like a dinosaur, this little planter that I'm doing. You guys can make it look like a cat, a dog, whatever you want. I picked a dinosaur. So the materials that I needed and the materials that I have are this water bottle. I have two cardboard things that I'm not really sure how I'm gonna make the head for the dinosaur yet, so I picked up two just in case. So this is gonna be like where I'm gonna cut this, and the plant is gonna sit in this, and then there's gonna be a head attached, things like that. And then I have my box of paints. I have a lot of paints. And then I have googly eyes for the eyes on my dinosaur, but you can paint the eyes if you want. And then I got these little colorful buttons. I'm not gonna use the big ones. I would use the smaller ones. I don't know if I'm gonna use those yet, just for decoration on my dinosaur. And then I have glue and scissors. So make sure that you ask your parent to help you if you need help with the scissors or the cutting or anything like that. Okay, so let's get started. The first thing that I'm gonna do is I'm gonna cut my bottle so then I can paint it. There's still some water left in here, so whenever I cut it, I'm gonna wash it out a little bit. I'm gonna take the top off of it. Here's what it looks like. Probably gonna need to cut around the edges a little bit more just to make sure that it's not like pointy, but I am gonna go wash that out. Okay, so now that I washed it out with water and soap and I dried it off, I'm going to try to cut the edges a little bit more smooth just to make sure it doesn't like poke me or anything whenever I'm like watering the plant or something like that. Okay, so now that I cut this part flat, as flat as I can get it, I'm going to cut out the head for my dinosaur. I am going to keep this part of my bottle because if this turns out like nice and I really like it, I might get another succulent and plant it in this one. And I would just glue the top onto this and kind of sand it a little bit flatter so it stands up straight. And then I would just do the same thing. So now I'm going to try to cut my dinosaur head. I'm not sure exactly how this is going to work, but I'm going to try my very, very best. So I'm going to cut this open, and I'll probably draw out my dinosaur first. So I have my pencil, and I want my dinosaur, I guess, to be about this high. So it's just the head that we're drawing. So if you're not very good at drawing like me, don't worry about it. I might have made him too big. All right, there's my dinosaur head so far. Okay, I'm gonna cut him out, and then I'm going to either glue him on here or do another edge, just to where it would be easier for me to paint it. So I'll glue this side onto this side, and I'll show you guys what that looks like. Okay, so I cut out two heads. This is gonna be my front, and I'm just gonna glue this one on the back to make it a little bit thicker. That way it doesn't have this print on the back. It just has like this other white print. So whenever I paint it, it'll be a little bit more simple. So I'm gonna glue this together, and then while we do the rest of it, this will be drying. So it's being glued together. I'm going to set my cup of water for my paint on top of it to hopefully make it stick a little bit better. Alright, so this stuff I suppose can be trashed. And now I'm going to wait for that to dry and then glue it onto this. Okay, so now that my head is relatively dry, I'm going to glue it onto this, like this. It's okay if you can see through it because we're gonna paint all of it anyways. So let me dab some glue here. And then stick it right there. And I'm just gonna hold it until it dries. Okay, so now that my head is glued on, it looks like this. I'm going to paint the entire thing white first, and then I'll pick a different color. Okay, so now that I have my base paint of white, I'm gonna go in with this royal blue and paint the whole thing royal blue. Okay guys, so now we're outside. I had to put a sweatshirt on because it's getting dark and a little bit cold. You can't really tell because the lighting from the building is pretty good, but our dinosaur's finished. I have 3 buttons in the back that aren't really dry. So I would actually suggest painting on your decorations, probably not gluing them on, but my eye is dry and you can see its little smile. So now I'm gonna take my plant and pot it in here. Let me pan down a little bit. Okay, so I have my potting mix. I use this potting mix, or I have been recently. This one was at Walmart for like $3 or something. I normally do use the Miracle-Gro potting mix. I do have some peat moss in the Miracle-Gro, and then some cactus potting. In the Miracle-Gro, but this one was just so cheap, and I feel like it's just as good if you have the Miracle-Gro with you. And this is a succulent, so it's not that big of a deal. So I'm going to take my shovel and dig a little bit into my potting mix so I can fill our new pot. And my succulent's a little bit small, so you can try it like this to see exactly how you want it. And so I'm going to fill it up a little bit more just to make sure that it pops out. And now I'm going to take it out of its original little pot. You can already see the roots are really good. And then I'm gonna spray it with my neem oil just to make sure there's no bugs or anything in the potting mix that's already there. Neem oil does smell really, really bad though. And then I'm going to add potting mix around my succulent. And I'm going to keep breaking off the dirt that's already around the succulent that came in the pot, just so it adds some more. And here is our finished dinosaur pot. Like I said, you can make anything. There was a little kitty cat with the little ear sticking up that I thought was cute as well. Like I said, I wouldn't suggest doing the buttons. I had a button right here and it did fall off while I was potting my plant. So I don't suggest doing the buttons, but hopefully it'll work out. If not, I'll just paint some on there. Do a quick little retake. All right, hope you guys enjoyed this. I'll see you again with another activity. So as you guys could see, I was using a hairdryer to dry my pot a little bit faster. And it did work. It did take a few layers to make it as dark as I wanted it. Now I'm just gonna glue buttons on the sides and one googly eye where the eye goes, and I'll probably paint a little mouth.